impressions, they say, are lasting. Now, what do we base our first impressions on?
Mr. McCabe wants Ferrone right away.
Whom does he want?
Joe Ferrone.
Is Joe Ferrone here?
Joe? That's a laugh.
He'll show when he'll feel like it.
I see. Now, we all know that first impressions... Is this 304? Yes, you're late. I'm not late. I'm absent. I was absent all last term. You're supposed to sign my book clearance from last term. Do you owe any books? I'm not on the blacklist. That's a yellow slip. This is a green.
Isn't the pass back yet? Don't you ever give up?
I'm afraid we won't have time for the discussion on first impressions. I'm passing out...
Hey, she's passing out! Get her here!
I'm passing out attendance cards. Please print in ink your last name first, your parents' names, your date of birth, my name, it's on the board, and the same upside down. Then I'll make out the seating plan. Any questions?
An ink or pencil?
Excuse me. Hey, teacher, I don't have ink, you know. Hey, who's got a pencil? Who's got some pencils along with me?
I don't remember when I was born.
Hey, don't mind him, Peach. He's just a comic.
Print or write. When do we go to lunch?
Maybe this is the wrong room. What room is this? This is room 304. My name is on the board, Miss Barrett. I'll have you for homeroom all term, and I hope to meet some of you in my English classes.
English? No wonder.
Who needs it?
First impressions, they say, are lasting. What are our first impressions normally based on?
Are you sure you haven't seen Joe Ferrone?
He isn't here. Class, will you please pass your attendance cards down now while I...
I didn't start yet. I need a pen.
How do you spell your name?
Excuse me, Miss Friedenberg from Guidance. Shoots Joe Ferrone right away.
He isn't here. Two boys in the back, please stop throwing the board eraser. Please come to order. Will you pass your attendance cards down, please, while I call the roll? I didn't start yet. I still need my pen. How do you spell your name?
Hey, you threw the eraser out the window!
Hey, will you please?
Here's my pen. He said I was wondering.
Who?
McCabe.
Mr. McCabe.
Either way.
Class, please finish filling out your cards while I call the roll.
Hey, I never got no card.
Any card.
You are?
Paul Behrens, your fellow teacher. I teach English, do you or not? Sorry to interrupt, but may I borrow a board eraser?
Yes. No, I'm afraid it's gone.
I could go get one for you, Mr. Behringer.
Never mind. Anyway, we have something in common.
What's that?
No erasers.
Sit down, please. I must take attendance. If I mispronounce any of your names, please correct me. Arbuzi Helen.
She's dropping out.
Oh, yes.
Mrs. Barry, the custodian says that there's not anybody down there.
How can he say that when he's down there?
No, that's just what he says. Any answer?
No answer.
Sure.
Blake Alex.
I'm present, Miss Barrett.
You're sure?
Oh, yes. Present.
Blanca Carmelita.
I've changed my name to Carol.
Blanca Carol.
Here.
Borden. Yes?
Miss Friedenberg wants the service credit cards from last year.
I'm in the middle of attendance.
She's from right away.
I wasn't here last term.
Second, the office wants to know. Are the transportation cards ready yet? Third, fill this out.
Not so fast. The what cards?
Transportation. Bus and subway.
I haven't even finished attending. Please don't tilt that chair. Point the back. I'm talking to you.
Hey, shut up, everybody.
Are you hurt?
No, my head.
You better make out an accident report. Three copies. Send them to the nurse.
And the nurse ain't even allowed to give out accidents.
Me. I'll let you sue the whole Board of Education.
Yeah.
You'd better go to the nurse and ask her for the accident report blanks.
All right. Go on.
There's more?
Yes. You're supposed to read this to your class. It's from the library.
Library. Class, the school library is your library. All students are encouraged to use it at all times. However, the library will be closed to students until further notice to enable teachers to use it as a workroom for their PRC entries.
I've got 11 more messages.
We'll get back to attendance. We won't get back to attendance. What is it?
New change in assembly program. Your class goes in different rows. X2 schedule rows.
I see.
And this is urgent from Mr. McCabe.
To all teachers, a blue Pontiac parked in front of the school has been overturned. If the following license is yours, tell Mr. McCabe I don't drive. Now, class.
Miss Barrett, the nurse said she doesn't have any accident reports. She wants some missing dentals or something.
Missing dentals?
Yeah.
We'll get to that later. Right. I'm going to take attendance, and then we'll...
Hey! Save for the bell!
All right.
Wait, please remain in your seats. The bell's much too early.
No, that was the bell! Well,
the teachers are letting them out.
Please remain in your... We haven't even finished the bell rings we're supposed to read. Where do we go? Assembly? Please sit down.
Bye-bye.
Looks like we're the only ones left. You're Alice?
Alice Blake. I want you to know how much I enjoyed your lesson.
Thanks. But it wasn't really... There's more?
Just one. You're supposed to announce this to your class right away.
Please disregard the bell. Students are to remain in their homerooms until the next bell. Thanks.
Maybe I should have given you this one first.
Maybe. And I thought I might begin with the importance of first impressions. Program cards, requisition slips, transportation cards, service credit cards. And the two columns labeled male and female kids indicate the number of students in your homeroom born between the following dates.
You bear it?
What's this?
Late pass.
That's no way to hand it to me.
My aim is bad.
There's no need for insolence. Please take that toothpick out of your mouth when you talk to me, and take your hands out of your pockets.
Which first?
What's your name?
You gonna report me?
What's your name?
You gonna give me a zero?
Look, I've had just about... What's your name?
Joe.
Joe what?
Bro, you gonna send a letter home? Take away my lollipop? Lecture me? Spank me?
All I asked.
Yeah, all you asked.
I don't allow anyone to talk to me like that.
So you're lucky. You're a teacher.
So I'm lucky. Hello? Room 508. B. Schachter. You said just holler. B, help!
Having fun yet?
I'm having problems. I don't think I even understand the language. A student called me Hi Teach.
Maybe he liked you. Why not answer Hi Pew?
I don't think I could ever bring off Hi Pew. And the paperwork. I'm buried beneath an avalanche.
That I can clarify. Let it be a challenge to you. That means you're stuck with it. Keep on filing numerical order means throw it in the wastebasket. Interpersonal relationships. That's a fight between kids. Ancillary civic agencies for supportive discipline. That means you better call the cops. Literature based on child's reading level and experience background means that's about all they had in the book room. Non-academic minded, that's a delinquent, and it has come to my attention, that means you're in trouble.
That I believe.
Did you get anything done in homeroom?
I took attendance, as far as B. A boy fell off a chair, and I forgot to have them salute the flag, which may be illegal.
On assembly days, they salute an auditorium. What's illegal now is Bible reading.
What about a short, silent prayer?
As long as the word prayer isn't mentioned, you don't move your lips. And remember, there's no such thing as a permanent pass to the water fountain.
What do I do about the PPPs?
Almost things, doesn't it? That's pupil personality profile invented by Ella Friedenberg, guidance counselor, thanks to Sigmund Freud. She bases her PPP interviews on questions such as, why do you hate your parents?
If I don't ask, how do I find out? Latent maladjustments may exhibit themselves in socially unacceptable behaviors in the classroom. This is a crucial period in the development of an adolescent. Send the new pupils to me for in-depth coverage and the disruptive elements to Mr. McCabe.
Mr. McCabe again.
Administrative assistant. He's very strict. I don't know, maybe he has to be. But try to avoid him. He's in charge of discipline and supplies. Can't bear to part with rubber bands. Ask him for a pencil, he turns white.
To all faculty, diligence, accuracy, and promptness are essential in carrying out all instructions. Teachers with extra time are to report to the office to assist with activities which demand attention. Regarding the requisition of supplies, please anticipate your needs. Do not make excessive demands. Any teachers wishing decorative posters, we have a few left. Block letters, blue on white, knowledge is power, and green on yellow, learning equals earning. Also, brown and tan of Swiss Alps, slightly torn, but still usable.
All students delinquent in obtaining athletic suits are to be alphabetized and reported. Girls who wish to be excused from gym are to be sent to me with all pertinent data.
Frances Egan, school nurse.
Please discourage excessive dieting in your homeroom.
No books are to be removed from the library until the card catalog is brought today.
The librarian?
Charlotte Wolf.
Do not encourage students to purchase paperback editions of Shakespeare and other authors. Because of outside pressures, we should not expose them to insufficiently edited or unexpurgated texts.
Samuel Bester, chairman of the English department, a brilliant teacher, so naturally he's promoted right out of the classroom.
Hello there, teachers. Looking forward to this school year. Easy Term Confidential Loan Company can solve all your problems.
At 18%.
Teachers should function according to instructions. This means hand in on time.
Sadie Fitch, school clerk.
Pupils will report back to their homerooms to be checked off at 2:56. Dismissal bell will ring at 3:05 sharp. This, however, is uncertain.
send legitimate latenesses to the lateness coordinator. If excuse is invalid or suspect, send offenders to me. Please read to your students a list of infractions and penalties to instill in them a sense of civic responsibility. Post in a prominent place, a student who is late may fail to graduate.
I have to go now. I'm trying to salvage a potential dropout.
The very first girl I called on today was dropping. Our boozy Helen.
I've got to drop out, Miss Barrett. I'm of age and my income is needed at home.
Why don't we talk this over, Helen? Perhaps there's some way we could...
Why talk? School is a waste anyhow. Every period, another subject. Algebra, French, eco, English. One after the other. What good is it?
Well, if you give me a chance...
It's all a jumble in every class. The teacher tells you something different till you don't know who to believe.
But before you make this step, it's going to affect your entire life.
Save your breath. I'm better off out.
Miss Barrett?
Sir?
It's come to my attention that you've neglected to fill out Form B-22, accident of a fall from a chair incurred by a student in your official class.
But he wasn't hurt. Mr. McKay, my real concern is that...
Please fill out Form B-22 in triplicate and return it to me before the end of the day.
Yes, Mr. McKay.
Thank you. You there. Just a minute.
I think you're expecting a little too much, Miss Barrett.
Admiring your penmanship?
Suddenly my name looks unfamiliar to me. I have a strange feeling I didn't even spell it right.
The school teacher who has everything.
A board eraser.
The cab wasn't around, so I took two.
You'll have to do better, Miss Barrett.
Suave cape you. I have a free, oops, an assigned, period. I'll be having coffee with teachers one.
Well, maybe I'll... If I can get through the locker assignments.
Then I'll see.
B. Schachter.
I'm with the child.
Then quickly, you haven't told me about Paul Behringer.
Glamour boy of the English department, unpublished writer. He'll woo you with his rhymes. You're on your own with that one.
I see.
A moment, Miss Barrett. Was Ferron in homeroom? Did he stay till the bell?
He was a little late, but he stayed till the bell.
You're certain? It's very important. A valuable wallet was stolen from a locker during homeroom, and I understand Ferron was seen loitering in that vicinity just before the bell.
Then it couldn't have been Joe. He was in homeroom.
Was he any trouble?
Trouble?
Disruptive? Rude? Any trouble?
No. No trouble.
You think it helps a cover for them, then you're very much mistaken.
Unless there's something else, Mr. McCabe, I'm going for a cup of coffee.
Better luck next time, McCabe.
Mr. McCabe.
Mr.
Every year I deal with a lot like you.
Please ascertain the number of students who have not had a hot breakfast. Now that winter is approaching, this is particularly important. Poor nutrition is frequently the cause of poor marks.
Calvin Coons Clarion, get your copy of the Clarion. Halloween issue, just out today. Important advertisements.
The corner coffee shop, where friend meets friend, compliments of the Vanity Corset Company.
Your education has been planned and geared to arm and prepare you to function as mature and thinking citizens. And I'm sure you will all prove worthy and deserving of our trust and expectations. Signed, Dr. Maxwell Clark, Principal.
Faculty flashes from the Clarion. Teacher that girls would like to be on a desert island most with, Mr. Paul Poet Behringer. Teacher readiest with unselfish helps, Mrs. B. Mom Schachter. The most glamorous teacher, Miss Sylvia Barrett. She's only been with us since September, but we hope she stays a while.
As a special Clarion has inaugurated a lost and found column. First we list lost.
Green plaid jacket, tore lining, broke zipper. Urgent need, signed, blue mark.
Makeup kit, imitation red alligator, Linda Rosen.
Hollywood Horoscope of Stars magazine, reward, Alice Blake.
lost or stole. My left lens for my eyeglasses between here and history. Edward Williams, Esquire.
Now for Pam. No Pam. Students, the Clarion is the voice of your school. Please subscribe. A special solicit ads to keep it talking.
All teachers, attention. Do not accept the latest excuse due to fire on the subway. This was checked with the transit authority by Mr. McCabe. There was no fire on the subway.
Mr. McCabe, Ms. Barrett, please note that Joe Ferrone has been placed on probation. A truant officer reports no such address as the one given. Subject teachers claim he's been cutting classes. Nurse says he's on dental blacklist. Lots of luck, Joe.
Watch the baby a minute, will you? It's a letter from my friend Sylvia. We went to college together, and now she's teaching in New York. A far cry from Professor Winter's lectures on the psychology of the adolescent. I've met the adolescent face to face. Obviously, Professor Winters had not. While you're strolling through your suburban supermarket with your baby in the cart, or taking a shower in the middle of third period,
I'm automatically erasing the latest graffiti from the blackboard. Even the building seems hostile. Cracked plaster, broken windows, carved up desks, gloomy corridors. I've been here only 2 months, and already I'm in a battle I'll probably lose.
Over the boy you mentioned in your last letter?
Joe Ferrone. Insolent, contemptuous, very bright, but flunking every subject.
Why fight for that one?
I don't know. Maybe because I sense something in his rebelliousness that's like mine. That's against the same things. Or maybe it's just because he's been so damaged.
You're a teacher. You're not there to fight for them.
I keep thinking of Maddie, who went to college with us. Right now she's at Willowdale Academy giving seminars on James Joyce under the philosophic maples.
What keeps you from Willowdale? That other teacher, Paul something?
Barringer?
Yes. Tell me about him.
All I know, he's clever, attractive. But there's something about him that eludes.
Eludes?
It's hard to say. For one thing, he waits till the hallway traffic subsides before leaving his room. I have a feeling he does this to avoid being touched by the kids. And he seems just passing through here, marking his time teaching till he becomes published and he can leave.
And you and the girl students find this intriguing.
Devastating. There's a girl in my class, Alice Blake, who's almost lovesick over the man.
The thing I really like about him, Miss Barrett...
Please, Alice.
He never sits behind the desk. Either he leans against it or he sits on top. And have you ever noticed one eyebrow is higher than the other?
Alice, the subject is Homer's The Odyssey.
I know. Also the myths and their meaning. But have you ever
noticed... I'm looking forward to your paper, Alice.
Yes, Miss Barrett.
Well, have you?
Have I what?
Noticed his eyebrows.
The one that's higher than the... What possible difference can that make? Have to go. I'll finish this later.
I think it's Paul coming. Love, Sylvia.
There's nothing the matter with Alice Blake.
Don't bump my head off. Especially now, because you're about to be immortal. I found a new rhyme for Sylvia Barrett.
Nothing rhymes with Barrett.
14 carat. Why did you insist on going home so soon last night after dinner?
Papers to mark.
No one should take it that seriously. You're put off by my bad mood. The latest rejection slip. The tone is not impolite, but patronizing. Why don't I write up something familiar?
Well?
What do they want me to write about? Calvin Coolidge High School?
Well, at least they couldn't say you're not familiar with it.
Kids sprawling in classrooms, yawning in assemblies, pushing through the halls.
That's the surface, Paul. If you get closer.
Do you get closer?
I'm trying. I haven't even found what to call them yet. Teenagers, kids, youngsters, young adults. Those expressions all seem stilted, inappropriate, even offensive.
Let it all go, pupil. Look. Sylvia, I've started a new novel. This one's gonna make it. Let's have a cup of coffee later and I'll tell you about it.
Sure, Paul.
A big subject. A nuclear physicist. He's marooned on a peninsula in Kamchatka.
I looked up Kamchatka. It's at the far eastern end of Russia, opposite Japan. Maybe he knows all about it. Maybe he reached Calvin Coolidge High via the Trans-Siberian Railroad.
More likely the subway.
Are you reaching the students?
No, but there was a beautiful moment yesterday. I put on the board a lesson on Browning's "The Man's Reach Should Exceed Its Grasp," or "What's a Heaven For?" And then we were involved. A spirited discussion. Aspiration versus reality. Is it wise to aim higher than one's capacity?
Yes!
Does it doom one to failure?
Yes!
And hope? What about hope?
Miss Barry.
Yes?
Can't you keep your class in order?
They're in order. We're in order.
Then what's the meaning of this?
The meaning of what?
All this noise.
The noise, Mr. McCabe? That's the sound of thinking.
There will be a series of three bells rung three times indicating shelter drill. The loud discussion does not encourage the orderly evacuation of the class.
Yes, Mr. McCabe.
I suppose he has his problems, too.
But keeping order is getting to be the important thing. Enthusiasm is frowned on because it gets noisy. I don't know that I'm reaching them at all. Maybe other English teachers are more successful.
Let it be a challenge to you.
How do other teachers... Class, can you tell me what you've gotten out of English so far?
Well, during my many years of frequenting school, I am well satisfied with my instruction. And I hope to achieve further progress in my chosen program of study.
What I got out of it is literature and books. But having boys in class distracts me from my English. Better luck next time.
I hope this term with you will be good, because you seem to be alive, though it's too early to tell.
Being that you're still new here, you should know that I make a deal with my teachers. If I don't bug them, then they don't bug me.
Edward?
Edward Williams, Esquire. All the teachers flunk me because I'm Native American. Frankly, I'd rather like them to tell me that I'm no good in English than give me dirty looks in the hall.
You know, what I learned in English is to doodle. Such a boring subject, because I spend a lot of my time doodling and passing the time.
Essays. A lot of gossip. I haven't hoes for the birds. George Eliot stinks, even though he's a lady.
A kaleidoscope, an ever-shifting pattern. Shapes come and go, leaving no echo behind. Such is my remembrance of lost and vanished hours from whence I arrived. All creativity stifled, yet a phoenix of hope still reborn. Will it be different this time? The question lies on the spear of time, still unanswered. I was supposed to have Miss Schachter's creative writing class, but because of conflict, I was unable to get in.
Sorry about that. Let me ask a more specific question. Why do we study myths? Like the Odyssey.
Because we want to talk like cultured people. How would you like it if you were at a party and somebody mentioned a Greek god that you've never even heard of? You would be embarrassed.
What good is integration if I still get hard assignments?
We study myths to learn what it was like to live in the golden ages with all the killings. If it wasn't for myths, where would Shakespeare be today?
We study myths because they are about love.
To me, the Odyssey was just another Ethan Frome or Silas Marner. Who wants to hear about someone's troubles?
Everyone has to read them, and now it's our turn.
Myths help us gain tolerance for others, even if we don't deserve it.
You read it because it's a classical.
In my opinion, the Odyssey was no good at all. I hated Homer. He's a lousy writer.
Why do you ask these questions? What are you trying to prove? No one in this school gives a damn about us, and it's the same at home and in the street outside. You probably don't care for my language, so give me a zero in vocabulary. Anyhow, I'm quitting the end of this term. Joining the dogs eating dogs in the lousy world you're educating us for. Don't worry, you'll still find plenty willing to play your game of bad, bad little lambs. Trot and step and get your nice, clean diplomas. Served on dirt. Yummy. I trust this answers your question.
You express yourself vividly, Joe. And your metaphors, from dogs to lambs, are apt. I'd give you higher marks than you'd give yourself.
before you decide to quit, we should talk. Can you see me after school today? There's so much...
I don't understand the big words, Steve. And I'm busy after school. Every day. You'll have to prove yourself in your own time.
First time you've ever been early.
I missed the class before this. President McKay.
Mr. McKay.
He said a few words.
Please admit Barrett to class. He was detained by me for going up the down staircase and subsequent insolence. J.J. McKay.
Think of that.
Take your seat, please. Did you bring your homework? Why not?
I didn't do it.
Why not?
I just didn't.
One day you'll have to prove yourself, Joe. You have so much you're not using.
I'm supposed to accelerate at my own speed. I'm supposed to compete with myself. Well, maybe I'm not so hot.
I happen to know your IQ, and it's pretty hot. Hurry along, please. We have a test today.
Aww.
And turn in your homework.
Homework? Someone stole my homework. Yeah, they stole it. Yeah.
You see, it's like this, Miss Barrett. I stayed up all night doing my homework. And when I was on the subway, I fell asleep. And when it came to my station, I ran through the doors not to be late, and I fell asleep on the subway. Left it there.
As I was taking out the assignment, my ballpoint stopped. I had to study French, and plus, the page was missing from my book, and I didn't have time for English.
Well, my brother took my homework instead of his homework.
Hey, if the teacher wants to know something, she needs to look it up herself, instead of making we students do it.
There's no room because my uncle moved in, and I have to sleep in the hallway, and I can't use the kitchen table.
The baby spilt milk all over it.
In those hours when I could do homework, I can watch TV instead.
What homework? Miss Barrett, I'm sorry, but my dog went on my homework.
All right, Lenny. That makes it unanimous. Not quite unanimous. Thank you.
Why so many tests, Teach?
I learned your name, Carol. Couldn't you learn mine?
We see you every day. Why do we have to be formal?
Because it's protocol, dummy.
You're a Teach. Why not call you Teach?
This doesn't seem to be part of your homework, Alice.
You didn't read it.
Read what?
Let me see.
It's a big heart with Paul.
Memorize all poetry, Baron.
Hey, leave her alone. I had it first.
His voice. The way his eyebrows go up.
That's enough. If you want your privacy respected, please respect it in others.
Honest, Teach.
Miss Barrett, put this away. Do not open the test booklet until I say start.
Teach. Yeah, I don't care if we don't ever open it, Teach.
Before we start, please pay attention to this directive. The fact that Thanksgiving falls when it does this year is creating difficulties with midterm examination schedules. Since there will be no final exams, midterm marks will count as 2/3 of the final mark. Students are to place on the floor all books, notebooks, and personal possessions. Students may not leave their seats for any reason whatsoever. The proctor is to approach them at their seats to answer questions. No questions are to be answered by the proctor. If a student desires to go to the laboratory, the proctor will escort the student to the door and summon a hall proctor who will escort the student to the laboratory. Male teachers will escort boys. Female teachers will escort girls. Students must understand the importance of high ethical standards.
His voice. The way his eyebrow goes up. How to describe the emotion. If I could die for you, Paul, like the Lady of Shalott you read to us about. Floating dead in the river under his window. And Lancelot, never knowing, saying only, she has a lovely face, the Lady of Shalott. In my bed at night, I pray to this feeling. Please make him love me, or notice me in class where I sit. Make him take me in his bold, throbbing embrace. When I look at the cracks in the ceiling, and how ugly everything is, I think it's unreal. My house and my parents. Real life is somewhere else. On moonlit terraces, in tropic gardens, foreign cities, darkling woods.
All right, class. Ready? Start.
Oh.
too, Alice.
Sylvia, hi. I see you have your tests underway. What do you think about while they're testing?
I think about... I should be thinking about this pile of due before three Ninios.
Are you on to the official gobbledygook yet? Can you translate the following? Illustrative materials.
Magazine covers.
Enriched curriculum.
Teaching who and whom.
Right again. What about all evaluations of students should be predicated upon initial goals and grade level expectations?
It means if the boy shows up, pass him.
You're coming along quick.
Hey, Barry.
Trouble. Yes, Joe?
I have to be excused.
We're in the middle of a test. Please continue.
Hey, what's the answer to question four?
I don't think we covered part of this.
No talking.
Barry.
Please do your best. Finish your test.
I have to go to the laboratory.
You have to be escorted.
So get an escort.
Keep your eyes on your papers. I don't see... Proctor! Call Proctor!
I'll be back in a few minutes.
There's no escort.
So what are you going to do?
I'm going to trust you. Do I have your word you won't get help or look up answers?
Sure do, Teach.
Does showing disrespect make you feel better, Joe? More important? A bigger man?
Some of these questions.
No talking. Just do your paper, Charles.
I'm not cheating. I'm left-handed.
Since 5 minutes ago?
Okay. Whatever you say. I'll do it right-handed.
I shouldn't have let him go.
Probably not.
I can't take the system so seriously. Did you get these absurdities? Lateness due to absence, high underachiever, polio consent slips.
I can match yours any day. Please disregard the following.
All teachers, at the end of homeroom period, please send those students who have failed to report for checkout because they've left the building to Mr. McKay.
How do we report students who've left the building?
It'll be a challenge.
I'm forced to camp through library lessons on mythology. Your students create havoc. They have no respect for the print page. Two of them took out books indiscriminately.
What better way to show respect?
Not only that, they misplaced the golden age of Greece, and they put bullfinch on the zoology shelf.
Ah, Miss Barrett. I plan to observe your class soon.
I see. Oh, Mr. Bester, the book room only has 11 copies of Romeo and Juliet.
Use Ivanhoe. They have 160 Ivanhoes.
I have some useful material for you, Miss Barrett, and a few more personality profiles. Lou Martin exhibits inadvertent hostility due to manic behavior patterns, and Eddie Williams must curb his paranoia due to socioeconomic environmental factors.
What am I to do with that information?
My biggest concern is Joe Ferrone. A dangerous situation. Explosive. He must learn to channel his aggressive impulses into socially acceptable attitudes.
Well, how? What do you suggest?
Nutrition. Make sure he has a hot breakfast.
I'm not his mother.
You stay out of this. He disrupts others and he skips classes. Every stairway is clearly marked an up stairway or a down stairway. He always goes the opposite. You must do something.
Miss Barrett?
Yes, Mr. McKay?
How dare you?
How dare I what?
Let him go out of the room unescorted.
He had to go.
Unescorted?
There was no hall proctor.
You should have waited.
Situation did not warrant waiting.
His exam paper may be invalidated.
Why?
He may have been looking up answers.
He told me he wouldn't.
He told you?
Yes.
And you believed him?
I believed him.
Go back to your seat, young man.
I believed him.
Good. Go and proceed. Eyes on your paper. Come here, please.
Yes, Mr. McKay?
This isn't the time or place to explain to you the gravity of your position. You had explicit instructions, you disobeyed them. When Frome finishes, put his paper aside.
He did not cheat.
They don't need your coddling. They need discipline. We have to punish them for every infraction. Because if we don't, they'll get it later from a cop or a judge. Ever been in the juvenile court? Sure, we've got to win there. You've got to win their respect, but there's just one way. Strict enforcement. There's a strong possibility your end term rating will be a U. You see them? Keep track of them.
When the bell rings, please bring your examination papers up to my desk.
I finished early, Miss Barry. Actually, I do write left-handed sometimes.
Hope I did okay, Miss Barry.
I'm sure you did, Lou.
I mixed up my homework. Maybe you're sticking up for me. Right.
It was a hard test, Miss Barrett, but that's not your fault.
Here's mine, Miss Barrett.
Now you have to mark on such a long day for you, teach.
How nice.
If it was up to me, I would say you're very satisfactory.
Yeah, it's very well prepared.
Oh, man.
Miss Barrett, here's the flowers.
Homer really isn't such a lousy writer. If you say so, I'll give him another chance.
It's optional, Lenny.
Well, in that case, I'll give another chance for you.
You may fool them, but you don't fool me. You're even funnier than the others, because you put on this act. Being a dame, you don't have. Pretending you give a damn. Who do you think you're kidding?
Anything else, Joe?
Nothing else. Nothing. Too bad I can't believe you. That's all.
It's from Sylvia. She says she's beginning to feel like she's not communicating with anyone. You'd better communicate with Maddie. How are you going to answer her letter about the February vacancy at Willowdale? Tell me about Willowdale.
It's a small suburban college. Pleasant, cozy. Maddie writes they have trees in the windows and sit in leather chairs and sip coffee.
Miss Barrett?
Yes, Dr. Clark?
This comes to my attention due to laxness on your part. One of our students is under suspicion of cheating. This can have a very demoralizing and corrupting effect, and I find your actions upsetting and disturbing.
Yes, Dr. Clark.
And, incidentally, in looking over your record, I saw a note from the payroll department about a salary overpayment of $1.75 for last June. That overpayment should have been taken care of long ago.
But I wasn't even here last June. Dr. Clark, I didn't start till...
Sylvia, is there any reason for not applying to Willowdale?
No reason, except I like high school kids. I chose to teach here. Nobody forced me. It was my choice. And in spite of everything, I've got to keep trying.
You feel your reach should exceed your grasp?
Miss Barrett?
Have to go. I'll phone tonight around 8.
That phone call should have come tonight. I wonder what happened.
Miss Barrett, I need help.
What's the matter?
I did something so stupid I could die.
What is it?
The letter.
What letter?
To Mr. Barringer.
Alice, sit down. You wrote a letter to Mr. Barringer?
You have to get it back. I mean, any minute
I can't do that.
It's in room 309 on his desk. There was no one around and I left it on his desk.
Well, go over to 309 and get it back.
I'm afraid. Suppose he's there. Suppose he read it. How could I face him?
What's in the letter, Alice?
It was a terrible mistake.
Then get it back. Just go.
I can't.
There you are. I received your letter.
Yes?
I'd like to speak to you about this letter.
You do?
I'd like to see you privately.
See me?
privately?
Excuse us, please.
Yes, mister. You want to talk about my letter?
And make a few corrections.
Corrections?
Use a series of dots instead of punctuation. Let's see now. Dear Mr. Byrne, last Sunday I took the subway to your stop. Insert comma. Having looked it up on your time card, dot, dot, dot. I hope you don't mind the presumption. That's misspelled. I walked back and forth across the street from your house. Insert comma. Back and forth. Insert comma. And my heart was throbbing with this love I bear for you. Dot, dot, dot. Throbbing is a cliche. I think of you all the time. Dot, dot, dot. I pray to be worthy of you. And if you ever need me to die for you, I will gladly do so. I feel so deeply the truth and beauty, cliches, no need to capitalize. But I have to speak out this love I feel. Dot, dot, dot. There are some repetitions here and a change of tense, along with...
What did you do?
I handed her letter the only possible way.
How?
As a composition.
Oh, no.
Yes? What does a neurotic adolescent know about love?
Probably much more than you know about a nuclear physicist marooned on Kamchatka. I understand there's been a vacancy at Willowdale Academy in the February term, and it is in this connection that I'm writing to you.
Suggestion boxes.
She's asking for it.
It's almost the end of the term. Why start innovations now?
Because she can't wait. She's a masochist. That's a high school teacher who sets up suggestion boxes.
Teachers are always telling what's wrong with us. What about the other way around? I wish they all had suggestion boxes. Boy, would I like to tell them off. You're okay, Miss Barrett, for a teacher. You say we gotta have the courage of our convictions and sign our names. We don't have to, so I'm not.
Not enough boys and too many girls. But that's not your fault. Also, in some schools, they put on dances and have other things in the cafeteria. Why not? You only live once. Signed, Linda Rosen.
Abolish prejudice. Abolish Miss Friedenberg's stupid interviews. They make me sick. Like when she asked, am I ashamed where I live? Edward Williams, Esquire.
I don't like the way you dress. Too loud for a teacher. And you're a low marker. Signed, your enemy.
Teachers are ruining America. This is positively the last time I'm reading to you. Signed, Signed, the Hawk.
You seem to be a very understandable person. By that, I mean you understand us, not being too old yourself. Too bad you're a teacher and pretty like my sister. Then we could be close. Signed, Vivian.
The way you read is too emotive. You have pets, like Joe Ferrone. He's your pet because he gives you so much trouble. Signed, Neglected.
You're a good teacher, except for the rotten books that you make us read, like the Odyssey. I wouldn't give it to a dog to read. Signed, Disgusted.
Is it okay if I start collecting money from the homeroom kids to send flowers to Alice Blake in the hospital? The thing is, we used to sit in front with each other. Signed, Carol.
On Mondays, what do you think we are? Orators? Signed, Mark Anthony.
It is my considered opinion that you are very well qualified. No matter how boring the lesson, you always make it interesting. I suggest you keep up the good work. Harry A. Cake.
Clean up the slums before you go to Mars. And stop the bomb before it's too late. And as far as school, without us, there can be no school. And no futures. Lou Martin.
Would you please tell Lou Martin to quit showing up? He thinks he's so common. Well, I don't. Signed, Serious Students.
Don't worry, Miss Barrett. We're behind you, 65%.
Thank you for showing me that there's nothing more important than communication. But with so many other students, I feel that we're both wasted. Carol.
I'm not a good penman, but I must tell someone. I mean, I'd like someone to know. I'm putting this in the suggestion box for the record. Today is my birthday. Happy birthday. Signed, me.
You've written something brilliant again?
A parody of Ezra Pound, in many cantos, which I plan to lay at the feet of our dedicated colleague. Is Sylvia back in school today?
Yes.
Where was she at yesterday?
I haven't spoken to her yet.
I'm the villain. How would you handle a love letter from a student?
I have no idea.
Is Sylvia back? I have a problem about Alice Blake. She used to listen to Sylvia's official class.
What's the problem?
An overdue book. She owes the library 49 cents.
What book?
The Idylls of the King, Alfred Lloyd Tennyson.
You could always send a posse to the hospital.
I feel like a ghoul, but this is a matter of record, and not the first time. I had to warn her constantly about overdue books.
Doesn't it get you a little excited that a student really cares to read?
I used to get excited, but with no help, no books, and constant demand, all I care about now is for some shred of library to survive.
Right now you need 49 cents.
Right now I'm caught up maintaining the rules I didn't make. But paying the 49 cents would make you feel better.
I wish it were that easy.
I remember your comments in the teacher's lounge. Getting involved does them no good. So okay, Paul, think only of yourself. Amuse attachment, you said. That's the only way to remain intact.
I'm not sure it's possible to teach and also remain intact.
Make up your mind.
As Ella Friedenberg would say, I have a problem.
But you're working on it.
All I really care about is maintaining my amused attachment.
Oh, come off it, Paul.
I have another parody for you. Gray's Elegy. The school bell tolls, the knell of starting day. I do not ask for whom it tolls.
I see the students standing where it's pushed their screaming way. I know a lass that talks for thee and me.
That's very clever.
I have some others here, also very clever. When you were in school yesterday, I was afraid you'd left us. Glad you're back.
He's a lot more upset than he shows.
Perhaps. I couldn't even talk to Alice. She's not having visitors.
That's what I hear.
Miss Barrett, why have you neglected to send in your attendance sheet for today?
Because Linda Rosen wore a pink sweater and fuchsia stretch pants to school. She was seen by Mr. McKay, who had her cooler heels in the office. She was also seen by the boys in my home room, who migrated en masse to her vicinity. I'll take attendance later, unless they follow her like lemmings into the sea and are all drowned.
I'll inform Mr. McKay.
She had only one comment about Alice's accident. Hand in before 3, locker number and book receipts for Blake Alice. Mr. McKay urges us to keep our public image intact and our students in their seats. Dr. Clark urges us to be aware of our responsibility in a democracy.
What else can they say?
I don't know. Some indication that they care about the girl. Are we supposed to be uninvolved?
There was nothing any of us could have done for Alice. She was having a very rough time outside.
How do you know?
Once, she came to me beaten black and blue.
Beaten? What did you do?
Gave her a cup of tea.
Tea? Why tea?
What else could I do? I know more than anyone else here about what goes on outside. Poverty, disease, malnutrition. Yet I'm not supposed to even give them a Band-Aid.
But
isn't it? I used to plead, bang on my desk, talk myself hoarse, arguing with kids, parents, social agencies. Nobody even heard me. So I give them a cup of tea.
But you're a nurse.
Have you read the directive posted on my wall? The school nurse may not touch wounds, give medication, remove foreign particles from the eye, and so on and so on.
I didn't realize.
So I pass out notes and hand out cups of tea. Poor nutrition is frequently the cause of poor marks. I don't know if anyone pays the slightest attention. That's it for me. That's what I can do.
Nothing is our fault. There's nothing we can do. Nothing's our fault except, perhaps, poor teaching.
Are we teaching? Are we even getting through? Or are we just talking to ourselves?
You were missed yesterday. I had to go down and rescue your substitute. Your kids were turning her into a nervous wreck.
Why would they do that?
Misguided loyalty.
To me?
You wouldn't believe the lesson anyway. She was having them turn great poems into newspaper headlines.
Such as?
Midnight Rider warns a foe. Seaman, guilty of shooting bird.
Wife tells all in Portuguese love letters?
Not bad. Man reports talking raven.
Maybe I should stay away.
Where were you yesterday?
I have a feeling my end-term rating is going to be a big fat U.
No one is rated unsatisfactory unless certified loony.
That's not entirely true, Mrs. Shocker. Regarding your requisition, Miss Barrett, we are all out of erasers, all out of red pencils. Our order for window poles was sent to the board last spring. We must be patient. There's been an epidemic of chalk stealing. Please keep chalk under lock except when in use. However, we have some posters. Blue on white, knowledge is power, and yellow on green, truth is beauty.
Mr. McCabe, what I really need
is... We must be patient. Also, a frivolous attitude and levity of tone towards attendance taking are unsuitable for the high seriousness of our profession.
I'll try to cut down on the levity, Mr. McCabe. Have you had a chance yet to go over Joe Ferrone's examination paper?
Of course. So has Mr. Bester.
Well, I've been waiting to hear. I dare say Joe Ferrone has, too.
His mark was 86.
Any evidence of cheating?
You'd have heard.
No evidence of cheating?
That's right.
Then shouldn't something be said?
Why?
If not to me, at least to Joe Ferrone?
Why?
I'm hoping he'll stay in school.
He should not have been let out of the room unescorted. He knew it, and you knew it. The fact that he didn't cheat...
should be noted.
To what purpose?
No one likes to feel unsatisfactory.
If you're concerned about getting a U...
I'm concerned about so many things, Mr. McCabe.
And you think you can handle the Joe Ferrones? You try running this school for one day. You'll have a riot in every class.
All I'm asking, some strong things were said. Now we know he did well. And since it was entirely on his own...
This time...
I'd like there to be a next time.
We'll always have more than we can handle. We've got to be realistic. You weren't here yesterday.
I spent the day at Willowdale Academy, being interviewed for a possible February position.
I see.
I was being realistic.
Yes. Yes, of course.
You upset him.
McCabe?
He's upset.
Not McCabe.
vote is 3,000.
It's such a different world at Willowdale.
You mean nobody shouts, "Hi, Teach"?
I mean, I'd only have 3 classes a day, 3 times a week. The other 2 days left for seminars. I might even be able to give a seminar on Chaucer.
If that's what you want.
I want to practice my profession, that's all. I want to be like Chaucer's Clerk of Oxford. Gladly would he learn and gladly teach.
I have to go now.
Anything else happening here while I was gone?
Life is happening here.
Don't worry, Miss Barrett. We're behind you. 85%.
My mother has been living with me for 17 years, and she still insists on cross-examination. Please talk to her. Linda.
I know school's supposed to help me with life, but so far, it hasn't. Rusty.
Tell us more about your own life. It makes you feel very human. I'm only miserable at home and never in English. That's why I have this great ambition to be an English teacher. Signed, Vivian.
Teachers give tests for spite and to get even. You said we should sign our names. Signed, Anonymous.
When you call me to answer, don't call me when I don't know the answer. It makes me look dumb. Frankly, I'd like teachers to tell me I'm dumb, then do this.
You have one of the best sense of humor I've ever met. You make lessons laughable. And thank you for showing me that writing clearly makes thinking clearly. Carol.
Will you marry me? This is positively the last time I'm rigged to you. Signed, The Hawk.
I enjoy the way a tone of voice makes poetry sound, and changing it to sadness or happiness, depending on the poem. I went to the library to look for more Robert Frost, but it was closed. Charles.
You never call on me, and if you do, it's very seldom. Vivian.
I'd like to thank you for taking an interest in mine and the class as a whole's grammar. Harry A. Kagan.
Cafeteria lunches are lousy. Signed, Your Enemy.
I'm nobody special, so nobody knows me. But maybe if I drop out and get a job, I'll be somebody with a job. Sign, me.
Give me one good reason why I should stay in school. Sign, Joe Perrone.
I can give you many good reasons.
To take one of the cage dishes out?
Joe, it's time we talk this out. Stay after school today.
What's in it for you?
I'm beginning to wonder. For the time being, let's just say it's my job.
If I didn't know better, you'd even convince me. Save it for the sheep.
Joe, about our talk.
Miss Barrett, I'm slipping this in your suggestion box as the most likely place to catch your attention.
You've got it.
There's a rumor you're leaving at the end of the term. Why on earth...
Let's just say I couldn't find the proper response to "Hi, Teach."
I wish you'd reconsider.
Why?
Because if you leave, where else will I get such ghastly honest literary criticism?
Are you sure you want criticism?
No, but just to say, you're needed here. You're our spokesman, our infighter, our catalyst. And besides, you laugh good, like an English teacher should. I'm not just saying this to get a higher mark. Signed, Paul.
Paul invited me to the end of the term party, but I just couldn't go. I mean, how could I celebrate with a man who corrects a love letter? You're leaving for Willowdale soon anyway, so what makes the difference?
The term ends this week. There was so much more I wanted to do.
Like turn the Frome boy into a model student?
It's not a model student. It's not a question of that. I suppose Harry Kagan's a model student. He's also a stuffed shirt. There's so much more to Frome, but I can't seem to make any difference to him. And that's it. That's probably the one and only compensation. Making a permanent difference in the life of a child.
In your first letter, you quote a kid who says she's better off out. As far as that school is concerned, maybe you are better off out.
Miss Barrett? Ah, Miss Barrett. I'd like to speak to you.
Have to go. I'll write as soon as I can.
Love, Sylvia.
I have some unofficial comments on your teaching. Not those that will appear on my formal observation report.
I see.
The lesson I observed was an interesting one. Was there a reason for choosing Robert Frost, The Road Not Taken?
I wanted to lead them into a discussion of
blazing a trail versus conformity, and to the regret inherent in any decision.
Certainly apropos.
Mr. Bester?
My comments, Father. Ask your question first, then call the student by name, as you engage the whole class in thinking. Avoid vague or loaded questions. How do you feel about this one? Vague. We regret what we haven't done. The teacher obviously expects this.
I see.
The boy next to me was doing his math. A teacher should move about the room. Immediate correction of English was effective, but you missed. He should have took the road, on this here road, and he couldn't make up his mind.
Couldn't.
I like the way you handled the hostile boy you came with. The one with the toothpick in his mouth? You made him feel that the class had missed his contribution. But you should have made him remove the toothpick.
I've been fighting a losing battle with that toothpick.
Well, winning. And don't let a few students monopolize the discussion. Call them the non-volunteers. I'm not sure you're putting your energy where it's most needed.
Sir?
The cream will probably rise to the top anyway. Where help is most needed, Miss Barry, is with the skim milk.
I appreciate your criticism, Mr. Bester.
The lesson I observed was a fruitful discussion of choices. But what really concerns me is your choice. But I see you have a class. My formal report will follow.
Before you take that, I have a piece of creative writing. I started scuttling like a crook, making its fearful way stealthy among the dirty dishes crusted with grease. Bearing food to the secret sons behind the drain board. How fearful were his eyes. Shall I kill him? Miss Barry, isn't it clear that I'm writing about a cockroach?
Crystal, but the subject is Macbeth.
If you start to stifle me too.
I want to hear from some others. Do you have your homework for Macbeth? Carrie, good. I've been waiting all term for you to raise your hand. What's your question?
Do you wear contact lenses?
Only when I read Macbeth. Have you read the scene for today?
Not all the way. I mean, you already know who did it.
Let's start at the beginning.
Right, the way I
Charles.
See
the title is called Macbeth.
The title is?
Macbeth.
Didn't you read it last term in English?
I never read it before.
I've never read it.
Me neither. In this book, the author depicts.
Depicts?
This murder.
We're talking about the theme, not the plot. What's the difference? Linda.
The plot is what they do. The theme is how.
Not exactly. Vivian?
The theme is what's behind it.
Behind what?
The plot.
Ooh, spare. Miss Macbeth nudges him.
Nudges?
Nudges, being a female, spurns her on.
Edward.
Edward Williams, Esquire.
Esquire.
The theme is, he kills him for his own good.
Jose.
Me?
Yes, you. Well, Jose?
I didn't volunteer. I didn't have my hand raised.
But I'm calling on you.
My name is Barrett.
Did you read it, Jose?
Yes, but...
Well, what would you say is the theme?
I didn't volunteer.
But we'd like your opinion.
Well, if you ask me, I...
Jose!
The author tries to show...
Tries? Doesn't he succeed?
He tries to say...
He says...
That he mustn't be ambitious.
Does he say ambition is bad?
Yes, very bad.
Jose! Isn't it good to be ambitious?
Well, yes, but not too.
Not too what?
Ambitious. Too much ambition is not so good.
So you're saying excessive ambition...
can lead to big trouble. That's
right. You're right, Jose.
All right.
I'll have to call on you more often.
I guess the theme, right?
Uh-huh.
What about... come on, call on me.
It's Barrett!
It's Barrett!
Real villain is Miss Macbeth.
He was led on by the witches. Right at the top, egg him on.
Bubble, bubble, toilet trouble!
Hey, remember when she hung us off Alabama spot? She would have kept her mouth shut.
How's the bell, Joe? School's out.
I heard it.
Is there something?
You kept asking me to stay for a talk. Okay, I've stayed. Here I am. How about that?
I see.
What do you want to say? Let's go. Let's have it.
I've been going over your entire record, Joe. I'm struck between the discrepancy between your capacity and your achievement.
Would you mind putting that in
English? How about, I don't understand the big words teach. And you could keep asking me to repeat. You could drop some books. You could rock on your heels. You could...
Okay.
This is important, Joe. To both of us.
My discrepancies?
Your capacity.
What's it to you? What do you care?
I do.
That's what you told me before.
Don't drop out. Joe, listen.
Are you listening?
I'm trying to.
Are you gonna be here?
Joe.
It's a straight question.
Then I have to say no.
No what?
I won't be here.
You won't be here. I see. Well, thanks anyway.
Joe, that doesn't mean
that... We finished our talk. What makes you think you're so special?
Sylvia, are you all right?
I remember the first time I was able to excite a class with an idea. The lesson on Browning is a man's reach should exceed his grasp, or what's a heaven for? It made me feel special.
Are you reaching for something?
I'm falling flat on my face.
What's happened?
How do you stand up?
Seriously?
Yes.
Walk through the halls. Listen at the classroom doors. In one, a lesson on the nature of Greek tragedy. In another, a drill on who and whom. In another, a hum of voices intoning French conjugations. In another, silence, a math course.
Yes.
Whatever the waste, stupidity, ineptitude, whatever the problems and frustrations, something exciting is going on. In each of the classrooms, all at the same time, education is going on. Young people exposed to education. That's how I managed to stand up.
B, am I a dropout?
Don't be silly. You do what you feel's best.
For the first time, I've been seeing myself through the eyes of others.
Whose eyes?
Well, for one, Joe Ferrone.
Get past the words, Sylvia. Get to what they're really saying. I have to go now. Another salvage problem.
Thanks.
Get to what they're really saying.
I don't know if you've noticed, Miss Barrett, but since coming to you, I've decided to dress more conservative. And now, I only wear eyelashes on dates.
When I turn 17, my father says, why should he feed an extra mouth? What I'm saying, Miss Barrett, is I hope I come back.
You give me a liking of school which I previously lacked. If Alice were here, she'd sign her name too, so I'll sign it for her. Carol and Alice.
English would be a lot better off with more teachers like you take an interest instead of just teaching due to circumstances. I'll never forget you as long as I live. You made me feel I'm real. I used to sign me, not anymore. Jose Rodriguez.
Miss Barrett, what makes you think you're so special? Are you listening? What I said, what I'm saying you're so special. You're my teacher, so teach me. Help me. Hey, Teach, which way do I go? I'm tired of going up the down staircase.
May I have your attention, please? This is your principal speaking, Dr. Maxwell Clark. And I wish to take this opportunity, on the first morning of the first day of the February term, to extend a warm welcome to all faculty and staff, with a sincere and earnest hope that we can go forward and upward together.
Hey, look! We got Miss Barrett back!
All right.
The only good thing about this place.
Go ahead and take your seats, please.
What's the date?
It's February, moron. Happy to recontinue, Miss Barrett. Could do it for us, eh?
You'll have to fill out the new attendance cards.
I'm not ready for creative writing this term.
Please disregard notice about disregarding the bells, please.
The school library is your library. No students left the library until further notice.
Hey, the window's still broke. We must be patient.
I'm glad you're back, Teach. That's from the heart, not the mouth.
Thanks.
Mr. McCabe said you'd read this to your class right away.
I'm about to take attendance.
McCabe says...
After attendance.
Right away.
All right.
Miss Bear! Oh.
Good morning, Rusty. Why are you late?
I'm not late. I'm not late. I had my English changed. I wanted your class.
I'm glad. Find a place.
Miss Bear, Mr. McCabe says...
I'm about to take attendance.
But he says it's
later,
important...
Later, Kevin. All right, class, I'm about to take attendance. If I mispronounce any of the new names, please correct me. Arbuzi Helen. No, that's wrong.
That's right. I got a job after school. I'm excited to give it another try.
Me too. Axelrod Leon.
Miss Barrett? Yes. Also wanted to ask, could you use some of these leftover posters? Blue on white, knowledge is power. My personal favorite. Or yellow on green, truth is beauty.
I'd love some posters, Mr. McCabe.
Very good. Continue with your attendance.
Axelrod Leon.
Him, he's always asking.
Yeah. You're lucky he's not here, Miss Barrett.
Hey, will he give you trouble?
Aaron's Charles.
You have to sign my book, please.
But Charles.
Thank you.
Charles, wait.
I'm dropping out, Miss Barrett.
Aaron's Charles. Dropped out.
Mark me present, Miss Barrett.
Joe Ferrone. Present.
Here's this.
What's this?
A book report.
That's no way to hand it to me.
My aim is bad.
We'll have to work on it.
On what?
Your aim.
I made it! I'm back!
Blue Martin behind you. 95%. Hi, Teach.
Hi, Pew. Acevedo Fiore?
Here.
Andur Janet?
Here.
Delgado Ramos?